everybody to Carole's Art Room. I'm going to do a tree ring pour today. I want to use up my paints that I've got Liquitex pouring medium in them, so I'm going to only have bits, little bits in each bottle. So I'm going to make three puddles, three tree rings. I'll put my mixture cups over here. Yeah, so I'm gonna just try and do each cup the same. So this is just a metallic white. I'm just pouring some in the bottom of each cup. Get them used up, and then I want to make a new recipe for my blooms. I haven't been too happy with the Liquitex pouring medium. Some of them have been nice, but I prefer Floetrol. Okay, so that's that. And I've got some cerulean blue. This will be probably very colorful. I'm just debating, should I do a blue cup and a pink cup? Or should I do them all the same? You know what I think? I think I'll do this one blue. This is a cerulean blue. Do the blue. So I'll make up a blue one first. This is turquoise, Liquitex Basics. So there's some turquoise. I got some green. This is a extreme sheen. So this is a metallic. And I'm gonna put some white. I mixed up some Artist Loft floor acrylic and my satin enamel 50-50, and I added some pouring medium and water. So I'm going to add a little bit of this in between each bit of paint. Maybe I'll get some cloud effect, we'll see. Okay, so now I have some light blue basics. I have left. I'll put a bit of yellow in this one too. I'll use this up. I have so many little bottles of paint with just little bits in them. I need to clear them up and start fresh with a new batch. It's a good way to do it. Just do a tree ring pour or a balloon dip. It's a good way. So then that's that. We'll add some more green. I'll put some more, finish off the cerulean blue. And I'll have a lot of washing to do. some more white. Gold. I don't think I have any gold left. Okay, that's that. I'll finish this off and then that should be enough for here. Historian, what is this? Okay, so that's a green and blues. I'm going to use now reds, purple. I have quinacridone magenta. I have Deco Extreme Sheen Rose. Some white. Some purple, deep violet. Reflex Rose, which is a bright pink. I don't have very much of this. All right. And then I have some pink, more pink, different pink. That's done. A little bit of red. Let me finish this red off first. Purple. Finish up. This deco art's done. this pink out of here. Here's a little bit of gold. Maybe I'll put some of the gold in here too. It's a bit thick. Some more white, I think, and then I think I'm good. Yeah, we'll finish it up. This will be interesting. All right, so I'm gonna spread some white paint. Just to give it something to move on. All these videos brighten up everybody's day. It's so nice to come and paint. Get your mind off the world troubles. Okay, so let me see, where am I gonna start? I think I'll do the pink one here and the green in the middle and the pink one over there. past that one. Oh, that's so pretty. It's quite a lot of paint here. I'm going to have a lot of pouring to do. Goes the blue and yellow. Enough of that. Whew, it's a lot of paint. And now it's gonna be interesting. I probably have too much paint, but I'm gonna do this. I'm going to stop now. Whoa. It's a lot of paint. So we can tilt into this. Come around, try and get you in camera. This is a big canvas for a close-up. Bring it back to the middle. I'm gonna bring it over here. Whoa. Wow, that green's pretty. Bit. See if that pink will move down more. Oh, I keep messing up my little sign. We should get that. I think I'll get my torch. I got some cloudy effect here. Oh, I love it. And I think it's going to dry so shiny. There's that green Perriot green extreme sheen in there. There's some pink extreme sheen. So I'm going to hold it up. And it looks like it's still reacting. I'm so happy. It's a good way to use up your extra paints. I'll hold it up so you can see those cloudy effects in the pink there. A little bit in the green over at the side. Great. Well, I'm glad you came by for this one, and I'm glad I did this one. It's beautiful. I love it. So have a great day, everybody, and come back to Carole's Art Room. And we'll paint together again. We'll see you in the next video. Bye-bye. Hi, everybody. Look what I found. I went to look at my ring pour, and it's changed since you saw it in the previous clips. Way more cloudy effects here and here. And wow, look at that. I have to show you. Close up. That was probably about a half an hour in between. It's awesome. Oh, there's the green part. Anyways, I'm gonna show you the dried results at the end. And I just love this one. Oh my goodness. And I wasn't even really trying for that. I thought, oh, I'll put it in just to see if it does it. But I'm happy with the ring pour. And when you don't try, you get it. And when you try, sometimes you don't get it. Anyway, that's the satin enamel and artist loft mixed together. Awesome. Well, thanks for coming by. And I'll put the dried result at the end. Hi, everybody. Just came to see my dried result. My cloud pour, ring pour. There's my clouds. Dried pretty good. like it. There you go. It dried smooth. Thanks for watching. Bye-bye.